Sometimes tenants pay after they stay. That's why you have to make invoices for overdue rent. What happens at the end of each month if the tenant has not yet paid? Well, the tenant still owes the money at the end of the month, whether they paid or not, and the landlord still earned the money because the tenant stayed there, whether they paid or not. You still make an invoice at the end of each month to reflect both of those changes. However, in this particular case, even though rental income is going up because the landlord earned it, you would not, I repeat, you would not take the money from unearned rent, and unearned rent would not decrease. If you did it this way, unearned rent would not be correct. Remember, unearned rent has to represent the balance of all the prepaid rent that the tenants have not yet used. If someone is paying late, it means their money never went into unearned rent in the first place, and therefore you should not be taking it out of the unearned rent account. Instead, when you make an invoice for a tenant who pays late, rental income still goes up because the landlord still earned the money, but another different account, rent receivable, that represents the past due rent from tenants who pay late, will be the account to go up because you earn the money, and this account, rent receivable, represents what they did not yet pay. Rent receivable is an accounts receivable type of account. Let's add it to the chart of accounts with the name past due rent receivable. So, from the main menu, click List, Chart of Accounts. From the bottom left, click Account, New. The account type is Accounts Receivable. Click Continue, and the name will be Past Due Rent Receivable. And now when we see this in the trial balance, we know it will represent the total money that all overdue customers owe us in total. For example, let's imagine on January 31, we're going to create invoice number 5 for Johnny in apartment 5C for the rent that Holden, the landlord, earned during January. Now, Johnny's rent is $700 per month. Johnny still owes the money whether he paid or not because he physically stayed in the apartment. We can print the invoice for Johnny and send it to him as part of encouragement to pay. We must make sure when we make the invoice that we choose the new account receivable account, past due rent. So how do we do that? Well, we click from the icon bar, invoice. Because that's what we do when we ask customers to pay. We choose Johnny. We put the date as January 31 of 2017. Remember, Johnny's rent is $700. But the most important thing to notice is this here. As soon as we added a second accounts receivable type of account, QuickBooks put this little pull-down menu to allow us to choose which one. In this case, the rent is past due. So when we click Save and Close, it will not adversely affect the unearned rental income account because this invoice has nothing to do with unearned rent. It's being created after Johnny stayed. This invoice is for past due rent. So make sure that that's the account that you choose in the top center. Click Save and Close, and when you open the trial balance, you can see that past due rent receivable shows up for the first time as $700. But what would be the result in the customer records? Well, When we look at the tenant balance detail and we look at Johnny, we see Johnny has a positive balance, which means Johnny owes us the money. That's the opposite of the negative balance that the other tenants have, because we owe them future services and future rent for them to stay into the future. When we look at the open invoice report, we see the other tenants have payments that are unused, but in Johnny's case, he has an invoice with no matching payments and an invoice that he has not yet paid, and that's why it stays on the open invoice report. So to update Johnny's records to make him the same as the other two tenants, let's do Johnny's February invoices for what Holden earned from him during February. Well, once again, click the invoice icon, choose Johnny. Now remember, this particular invoice is not for unearned rent because he's not paying in advance. It's for past due rent. So the item will be rental fees. Okay, the amount is still $700. And the date in this case would be February 28. Notice QuickBooks started counting the invoice numbers differently because it's from a different accounts receivable account. You can always manually change the invoice to what you want it to be at the moment that you make the invoice. When we click save and close, we can see his tenant balance detail. Johnny's balance keeps going up every month because he's not paying. And when we click on the open invoice report, we see there are two open unpaid invoices. And we know they're open and unpaid because we don't see any other payments with them to apply. Now let's just look at what happens if Johnny makes a partial payment for half of what he owes for just the first month, January. Let's imagine March 15th, Johnny gives Holden a check for $350. We assume that all payments are applied in date order to the invoices. That means the earliest payments get applied to the earliest invoices. So, we click payment because we're receiving payment. We're choosing Johnny, and Johnny's open invoices show up here. He paid with check number 1212, and he paid on March 15th. Now, when we type in $350 into the money amount field, when we push on the left of your keyboard, push the tab key to save just the field, QuickBooks will automatically apply the payment to the oldest one by placing the check mark here. You could always remove the check mark and place it on a different invoice, but we will not. We will let QuickBooks apply it in date order because that's usually the proper way to do it. Now we click save and close, and let's take a look at the tenant balance detail. His balance was up to $1,400 on February 28th, but then his balance went down to $1,050 on March 15th. When you look at the open invoice report, you can see that only $350 remains as the unpaid rent from Johnny for January, but the whole amount remains unpaid from Johnny for February. And of course, lastly, you can take a look at the trial balance and you can see past due rent has decreased to just only the amount that Johnny owes.